Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. So, I have not uploaded in probably a month, maybe even a little more than a month. And for those of you who like my videos or kind of keep up with my videos, you might be wondering where I've been, what I've been doing. Am I just done making YouTube videos or what? So here I am explaining everything. So this is just gonna be a chill video. I have no makeup on, hair is kind of a mess. I'm in a sweatshirt that says I just wanna hang out with my dog, which I'm doing, sitting right on my lap. So today's video is kinda gonna be a life update because I've tried to film probably at least 10 to 15 videos and I've either deleted the footage, I still have the footage on my SD card and haven't done anything with it, or tried to edit them and just hated it and didn't upload it. So I have tried to film and it just hasn't worked out. So I'm just gonna keep it casual. If you guys like my videos, you like watching me, and you guys wanna hear about my life, what's been going on, then go ahead and keep on watching. I wrote down in my notes a little bit of talking points because there's just been a lot that's going on in my mind and a lot that even like I feel like I haven't touched base with a lot of people, or even like Brian, who I live with and talk to every single day about everything. So we're first gonna like dive into just the whole YouTube world. One that I know. Okay, you're gonna sit right there. Okay, the first video that I uploaded was September 26th, so it's almost been a year. So after my last video that I uploaded, it wasn't something that I really loved. The past few videos haven't been something that I've really loved, so I took a step back and I was just like, why am I doing YouTube? That was my first question to myself, is why am I doing it? So I thought to myself, am I doing this in the hopes that I'll become some big YouTuber that'll make a bunch of money off of YouTube, or what is my sole purpose in doing YouTube? And I knew very quickly that obviously it'd be nice to make money and it'd be nice to have a lot of subscribers or whatever, but that's not my sole purpose in doing it, because if I'm being honest, like the having a bunch of people know who you are and all of that kind of freaks me out, and that's not something that I would necessarily want. I obviously want my message to get out there to a lot of people, but at the same time it kind of freaks me out. So if it happened, it happened, but is it something I'm dying for and that's the only sole purpose that I'm uploading a video? No. So I knew that I wasn't doing it for the wrong reason. So then I was like, well, if I'm doing YouTube, what kind of videos do I want to put out there? Like, I don't just want to throw out stupid videos that I'm not even proud of and that I don't like. So I think that a lot of people, I've said this several times, that I think a lot of people think I want to be some beauty guru. That's not it. Look at me right now. Am I a beauty guru? I'm not. Okay? I'm not. I used to really love makeup. As I've grown older, like, I'm more comfortable with my skin. I'm fine stepping outside, even though I do have redness and I have acne, but it's definitely not as bad as it used to be. And I think that sometimes my skin just needs a break. And sometimes I just like myself better without makeup. And I'm not that good at makeup. I don't experiment anymore. I do the same look all the time and I use mostly all the same products. So to have YouTube videos and make them makeup videos would be pointless for me, because I'd be putting out the same stuff and everyone would just be annoyed. And I'm not that good at it. I haven't really found my niche. I don't really know like what my content is, if it's just more like lifestyle, like I want to be able to vlog with you guys for the memories, like I want to look back on these videos and be like, oh my god, I remember when we did that. I love vlogging. I love having like my boyfriend or my friends in videos doing fun little like the yoga challenge, or like all the challenges me and Brian have done. So really, like, finding the type of videos that I like to film has been a struggle, and I've kind of taken this month to see like, am I made for YouTube? If like, what kind of videos do I even want to put out there? If I can't figure it out, then I shouldn't be on YouTube. So I've been kind of figuring that out. And then the last thing about YouTube that I have to say is that I don't really like the path that it's going on. I love old YouTube. The YouTubers I used to follow, like, a lot of them are done with YouTube now, but they were just so fun. They were so relatable. It was just cool to watch them. And now, no shade to any of these people, because I do like watching them. Some of it's like their personalities are just fun, but it's so high production that it's just kind of, I lose my my sense of being able to relate to these people. I want someone I can relate to, and now it's these high production lights, these fancy cameras, the crew, all this crazy stuff, and it's like, if I wanted all that, I think I would watch it on TV. So another thing is that I felt like I've fallen out of love with myself. And one of my biggest messages in my life that I love to preach to people I love, to anyone that I don't know, but I love them anyways, is to love yourself. That's like one of the keys to a happy life, honestly. It was one of the biggest things I've had to learn for myself, and I went through this self-love journey, and it was one of the coolest eye-opening things of my entire life. It was so cool. I had this new confidence. It was a great time in my life. But lately, I've kind of seen that go downhill. I've seen my confidence drop and my insecurities like build up. And I don't know what that is or why it's been happening. I'm still a pretty positive person and I'm pretty happy, but there's days when I just look in the mirror and I wanna cry my eyes out. If you saw my video about body image issues, that was like probably, it wasn't the start of it because I've had body image issues for a while now, but it's just been getting worse and worse and worse. And I've just been struggling with that so much that I don't wanna pick up a camera. I don't wanna talk to anyone. I don't wanna talk to anyone about it. And I feel like it's very hard for someone who struggles with those things to set a camera up and talk about it, you know, or just act like everything's okay, because sometimes you really just hate the way you look, or, you know, you don't love yourself, so you don't want to put yourself out there. And that's what I've been struggling with. It has been a long intermission since I filmed the last part of the video. The reason why is because my battery died. It's kind of been a sad few months of just feeling like I don't love myself anymore, and feeling like the message I'm trying to spread isn't accurate, or that I'm being hypocritical. Like, I want people to love themselves and I'm not doing the same. But it's just been a hard journey. Like, I want to be someone who's confident and confident about what they're sharing with other people, because when you start making videos or making stuff that you hold close to your heart that you really enjoy, putting it out there to people you know, people that you went to school with, dated, friends, family, that's being very vulnerable, because it's things that you had to build up the courage to put out there for everyone to judge and be critical of. And so making YouTube videos is not a normal thing where I'm from, where most of you who watch this are from, which is Ohio and Mansfield, a small little town. It's very weird to sit in front of a camera and make videos and then put them out on the internet. It's just very weird to some people and they don't understand it. But there's a whole world out on YouTube, and I find it very therapeutic and comforting, but at the same time, it's being very vulnerable, and people out there are open to judge you. And when you don't feel like you love yourself, it's like you put a video out there and then you're making assumptions about what people are saying about you, or you're sitting there rewatching every single thing, like judging your own self, and then imagining people judging you too, or just being very insecure like that, thinking that everyone has these bad thoughts about you. And that has been a huge struggle for me. So like being vulnerable enough to put things out there, knowing or thinking that people were like saying all these bad things about it, it has been hard for me. I've been struggling quietly. So to put that out in the world for people to know is hard. Kind of my last point that I want to talk about is I've felt really trapped lately. I got a job at a bank, and I'm gonna leave it unnamed. A lot of you might know where I work, but if you don't, I'm not gonna say the bank because I don't ever want it to seem like I'm bashing the bank or the company because they're great. But I took the job because I need the job, plain and simple. I did not grow up thinking that I want to be a banker, that I want to work at a bank for the rest of my life, plain and simple. Plain and simple. And I really thought my first day that I was not going to be able to do this, that I did not want to do it. It's been a struggle because I've grown relationships through the bank with my coworkers to make it more enjoyable, but I don't love doing it. I feel like this job sucks the creativity out of me. Every ounce of creativity, it sucks out of me. And that's not their fault at all. It's just that some people really like that. Some people are born to do that, and it's not what I'm born to do, and I know that. I think that this has given me a lot of experience. This is not a forever job for me. If you guys don't know, I think I've talked about it several times, but ever since I was younger, I've wanted to own my own clothing boutique. So many people doubt me. Makes me a little bit emotional. I'm trying not to cry. But a lot of people, I think, wow, I did not think I was going to be getting emotional. I think a lot of people don't think that I'm going to do that or accomplish that. And they just think that I'm going to be a banker forever, but that's not who I am. That's not what I want. I don't care if I'm 50 when I start my boutique, I'm going to own a boutique. No matter what anyone says to me, I have that drive in me. And I don't care what anyone says. If my family doesn't believe me, if strangers who ask me what I want to do don't believe me, like, if they think that I got my degree to be a banker, that's wrong. Like, I don't want to be just a manager of someone from a company. I want to own my own company and bust ass and be a boss. I want to be a girl boss. I am a girl boss, and I have it in me to own my own business, and I know I'm going to. So it's just hard to find that drive or find that belief that that's going to happen when you have people making you feel like it's not going to happen or being stuck in this job. Like, I want my business now. Like, I have all the plans for it. I know what I'm gonna do. I have all these ideas and plans. So I just wanted to sit down with you guys, be chill, have a conversation with you guys. If you do follow me, follow my life, want to know what's up, this is just kind of that video. I wanted to explain to you guys where I'm at, why I haven't uploaded videos. Not that so many of you have been hounding me for videos or even cared that I haven't made videos. I just wanted to let you guys know what's up, let you into my life, and give you an update. So if you guys enjoyed this, if you guys like hearing about my life, give it a thumbs up. But thank you guys for watching my videos. That means a lot to me that even 100 people watch my video. Thank you guys so much. I love to share what I'm going through on the internet so that you guys know that if you're feeling the same thing, you're not alone. And I'm always here to talk to anyone. I literally love every single one of you. You guys are the best. So thank you guys so much. I will see you in the next video. Bye guys. I was heading for a small disaster. You're supposed to be like, before you came around, I was ready to blow me down. You're supposed to ask this weekend.